Welcome to Puerto Lopez. And this is our own private little beach here at the Estadio Mandala. Coconut litter. So many coconuts, they just litter. So, there's our coconut tree, right? Seemed to be in the middle of the world right here. Let's take a look at the hotel. There's some more of Puerto Lopez up in the hills. Here's another taxi coming. Moto taxi. Seem to be here at the Mandala. Almost at the end of the road. Beautiful garden. And an absolutely incredible garden. Let me show you the way from reception to our hotel room. Some incredible flowers. Incredibly lush. And it's kind of a maze back here. Something like 22 rooms. Beautiful. This, I think, is my favorite flower I've seen so far. I think it's actually a vine. It grows off of this tree. This tree. And there's some Reina de la Noche. These downward facing flowers. It's not so hot, but it's very humid. Which way do we go? And here's our room. Got a nice hammock. And this is our hotel room. Got a little table and chairs, a fan in lieu of air conditioning, mosquito nets for the dengue fever, lots of windows, little closet, and the bathroom. Hi. Shower. Toilet. Sink. All right, I just have to say again that this has been like my best beach experience ever. The water is the perfect temperature. There's great waves, you float, everyone's having fun, there's no nasty shit on the sand, there's nothing floating around in the water. I've never had a better beach experience. On my birthday, we may go around that corner to Los Frailes Beach. It's supposed to be three different types of sand, white, black, and pink. I wish I'd taken some video on our drive down here. It's beautiful. Impoverished, but beautiful. We drove through a bit of the rainforest. So, that's it for now. More people being dropped off at the hostel. I also wanted to point out this interesting tree. It has interesting roots. They've got this nice little shower here where you can wash off your feet. But you shouldn't jump in too quickly because crabs live here. And they get very surprised. Don't step on them. And here we have the top of the stairs, the book exchange and lending library. Awesome little whale jigsaw puzzle. I do a lot of work with the Save the Whales organization. I sell t-shirts and CDs. It's just a beautiful room. Music. And up another set of stairs, we have the cactus room. Beautiful floors. The website's amazing, but it doesn't do it justice. Neither will this video. I hope you can hear the ocean crashing. He said that when they bought this place 14 years ago, it all looked like this. They said there was 3 meters of water on this land. And they turned it into that beautiful garden. It's not quite sunset, but it's high tide, I think.
But I think it smells like drops.
Do I?
Drops of rain.
Looks like we've got a storm heading in. Alright, we're right here about sunset. And also, I forgot to point out earlier, way out on the horizon, you can see.
Oh, that is a common picture.
That's the Isla de la Plata. You can delete it. That's the Isla de la Plata, where we may be going on Tuesday. Should have brought the tripod I here set up and just filmed the sunset. Thank you. went up to Washington on the coast. And we went to the northernmost beach in Washington.
The water
thing. Oh, yeah. It's a little island. We took a ferry out to an island called Whidbey. Whidbey Island.
Aquí se llama La Entrada.
Oh.
Este es el cambio de provincia.
Oh.
Sí.
Sí.
Aquí es provincia de Santa Elena, de aquí
sí.
para allá. Sí, sí, sí.
Sí. Por un momento.
Sí.
¿Qué es? ¿Cómo se llama?
All right. This is. We've just passed Alon on that road, and we are going to be going between Alon and Montañita. And there's a beautiful church right here. Iglesia. Es muy bonita. It's a beautiful church. We've been told to get closer. The white star of the sea.
That's a little motel right there.
Montanita is has popular.
Did you see that cat? Sitting right there by the road. He had a big head. El gato grande, veo.
Sí.
Baja Montanita.
What are you trying to say?
I'm trying to say I saw the blue buckets in the roof. Yo veo.
Volkswagens since we got here. Older and
they still build Volkswagens in Mexico.
And they also have a lot of Datsuns, but they don't make Datsuns anymore. They just last. And there's a bunch of shrimp farms in the area too. We just passed the construction of an oil refinery in the area. And this first condo place that we're going to is San Pablo. And then way on the other side is Linas. And they're constructing a big bridge out there. For a grand refinery. Or a pier. San Pablo?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh.
That was Korea on that sign.
Korea?
Yeah, and that blue sign is there. That was Korea with, I guess, some other politician.
Oh.
This guy's 6 minutes. Oh. Stop. We are now what's going to be the Malecón and Vallenita. There's some oil barges on the outskirts. It's a nice beach. oil frigates. I was so busy out in the water, I almost missed sunset. Our second day in Puerto Lopez, Monday night. Still deserted. About a dozen people on the beach. Low tide, the water's been receding. It's really forceful. So while it is nice on the beach, there looks to be a good-sized storm coming. And I can walk out a little bit further. Okay. Dark skies means the water may be too cloudy tomorrow for snorkeling. We're going up to the Isla de la Plata, which is there, about an hour and a half boat trip. Goodbye, Monday. If you wake up around 6:15 or 6:30, before sunrise. Well, it might not be before sunrise, but I can't see the sun. The beach is almost entirely deserted. There's three or four people walking around, one guy running, and me. We are going on the all-day boat tour to the Isla de la Plata today, which is still out there, barely visible in the mist. I just realized it's my birthday, so happy birthday to me. At low tide, the water recedes quite a bit. You can see the wet from high tide. And then that's the town of Puerto Lopez proper. You can watch cars going up and down that road all day long. And all the fishing boats. There's a huge stack of them down a ways, too. The water also leaves these beautiful rocks. All up and down. And this is the moto taxi ride to Los Reyes Beach. Uh-huh. Oh. I'm narrating. Muddy road to the Hesteria Mandala. They planted all of these palm trees along the way. These little boxes. Ooh.
that sign say Hindi or say Puebla?
I don't say. I've seen graffiti everywhere saying the Puerto Seguro with the number. And we're back to paved road.
Manchados.
Delfines manchados.
Manchados.
Actuando con
negro.
Sí.
18 grados, ¿sí? Pero acá, en el continente, es mucho más, el continente está la temperatura de 18 grados.
Not where I was.
De los chiqueros de patas azules, el masculino es más pequeño, bien pequeño, y su vocación es. Y la femenina es. El tamaño es más grande y su vocación es un poco más fuerte. Por eso es la diferencia entre el macho y la hembra.
Hey, 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 come on.
Parte de allá, para allá se mucho. No lo sabes. ¿Ah? Un tropical, ¿eh?
Thank you. campo de emergencia. Sí, yo veía que fui a alinear el carro. Mis llantas ya estaban con alambre.
Don't need it. Thank you.
¿Largo? Ah, gracias.
Sus arcas, querer ser los dueños de este país, volverlo a ser una hacienda. Pero compañeros, la autocrítica es importante y debemos construir.
Interesante vista de la parte moderna de la ciudad. On the right hand side, an interesting view of the new city. Solano Avenue, the left hand side, the monument of Remigio Crespo Toral, Mexican writer and poet. Y en la avenida Solano, de la izquierda, el monumento a Remigio Crespo Toral, escritor y poeta cuencano. Ahora a su derecha, the interiors of this building, based in the
We're still observatory, a viewpoint, top of Cuenca, complete with binoculars. Historic district, right around that cupola. The little
a keel from the airport before we leave. We pulled at the airport. And one last look at the city. The hill is covered in houses. No, but then
don't be on.